With version 10.1, VSDC lets you import and visualize GPS data from devices like GoPro, Garmin, and more, so you can show routes and elevation charts right inside your videos. Let's take a look at how it works. To get started, add a video that contains GPS data. The easiest way is to drag and drop a file that contains GPS info. VSDC will prompt you to create a GPX file, and that's exactly what we need for the charts. Just click Yes and head over to the Resources window. If you choose No because you weren't planning to use GPS data, but change your mind, no worries. Go to the Resources window, right-click your video with GPS data, and choose Import GoPro Telemetry. That will create a GPX file for you. Another way to add telemetry is just to use the toolbar on the left side of the scene. To display the data, drag the GPX file from the Resources window and adjust its length on the timeline. You can reposition and rotate the path if needed. Open the Properties window to continue its customizing. Want a quick setup? Use the Presets property. Now, let's explore more features of the properties dedicated to the GPX objects. One cool tool is Generate Google Maps Link. Choose, for example, Link to Start and End Point. Open the link in a browser, take a screenshot, and import it into your project. You can place it under the GPS path on the timeline for a neat reference. Move on to more detailed settings for GPX objects. To keep the route's proportions accurate, make sure Stretch Image is turned off. Then check out Path Mode. It lets you switch between viewing the route and showing elevation. We'll stick with the route view for now. From here, you can tweak the line thickness and even add animation. Feel free to copy our settings or adjust them to your own style. Now, if you enable Show Current Position, you can customize the look of the moving point on the path. Change its shape, color, and outline to match your video's vibe. The Enable Gradient option gives you even more control over how the path is colored. If you pick None, the path uses just front color and back color. Front color for the part already traveled, and back color for the full path. You can even animate the colors or adjust opacity using keyframes. Let's go back to Enable Gradient and explore the modes. Choose By Time and you'll see Start and End Color options. Your route will fade from one to the other over time. Pick by elevation and the color will reflect changes in height. Rising parts show the end color, while descending areas use the start color. And if you want more control, go into gradient settings to build a more advanced look. The text setting option lets you show any labels included in your GPS file. You can customize the marker style, text appearance and positioning to match your project. If you'd like to work with an elevation chart, we advise you to duplicate your chart. Go to the Path Mode option for it and select Draw Elevation as Line. The chart will instantly switch to an elevation graph, which you can customize just like the route chart, so you can see both types of display side by side. That's it for today. We continue working on our video editor, so stay tuned and do not forget to subscribe to the channel.